So as we get our practice underway, you can begin by doing a little legs up the wall. So as you approach the space, by bringing yourself nice and close to the wall space as best as you can, or if you have a piece of furniture that would be a little better to use, by all means, you can do that. And then just letting yourself start to find that nice little bit of release around your back, around your hips. Begin to feel the length in through your spine. And allow your shoulders to begin to broaden, feeling the release around the back of your neck, your shoulders, your upper back, and then providing space depending on what you have around you. If you want to do saguaro arms, you can do that. If you have space to go straight out to your sides, you can do that. If you want to get a little bit more length in through your spine, take your arms overhead if you have room that direction, and allow the arms to reach out and try to bring the tops of your hands or your elbows or forearms, all of that, try to bring that down towards the surface you're working on. And so when we just give ourselves this time, this space to evaluate what's going on in body, what's going on with the wind down from the day. Is there tightness stored up into the neck and shoulders? Is there tightness across mid to low back? If you've been sitting a lot today, maybe you're experiencing this more into your hips. So whatever is going on, just giving yourself this time and space to start to unwind and be respectful to your body. If having arms overhead isn't appropriate, then bring the arms down to a more comfortable height. And just letting your eyes gently close, feeling the release across your forehead, across your eyelids. Allow your eyes to draw back, feeling the comfort and the support into the eye sockets. And with that space of support, just begin to relax now across your jawline, letting go of any tightness. If you're not sure, drop your jaw, wiggle it around a little bit, feel the release taking place in through the jawline. As you allow yourself the space to acknowledge your physical body, again, being respectful of whatever shows up for you tonight. As your inhalation begins to deepen, feel the rise of your belly, the expansion to your lower and side ribs. And as you exhale, the ribs contract and the belly softens. The inhalation, belly rising. Ribs expand. Breath upward now to your collarbones. And then emptying upper chest, mid chest, belly. And this time as you inhale, draw the breath in slowly. And now pause here at the top. Observe how your lungs have filled, pausing still, holding at the breath. And now exhale to a slow count of 8, feeling the breath gradually releasing. Now pause here at the emptiness. Now inhale slowly to 4. Good, and then pause. Observe that fullness. And now inhale again, please. Really fill in to the full capacity. And now exhale to 8. Let's draw the breath in to a four count. Pause and try to inhale again. Hold and now exhale to eight. Now return to your natural flow of breath, allowing yourself to really experience that stability in through the lungs, that little extra drawing in on the inhalation after you pause allows your lungs to really draw in and expand one last time. And then with that slow emptying taking place, just letting yourself acknowledge the upper back, the shoulders beginning to melt down once more. And from here, let's give a little wiggle now to the toes, to the ankles. And depending on the surface you're working on, if it's a piece of furniture or if it's at the wall, I'd like for you to now give a bend to your knees. And as you bend your knees, I'd like for you to bring your right ankle over to your left thigh. Right ankle, left thigh. Now, if you're working on a piece of furniture and your feet are flat onto the side of the furniture, or if you're on your bed and your feet are flat to your bed, not a problem at all. Just take your time. If you're working at a wall space, just letting yourself start to find the comfortable bend to your knees so you're not overdoing. Our main emphasis right now is here into the right hip and the right side of the buttocks. So we're really getting that nice deep stretch taking place. And again, we want to take our time. Some days when we do our practice, it's like this big knot. And then other times it's like you're Gumby and you can easily move into the poses. So find that happy medium space that's for your body tonight. And another option is if you're really tight and you cannot bend your left knee, you can always keep your left leg straight, or you can even wiggle away from the wall a few inches so that you can start to bend at the knee. Right knee should feel comfortable. We're not placing any kind of strain into the right knee at all. Allow your breath to deepen, please. Empty it out slowly. And one more, full inhale, deep, deep, deep. And as you empty it out gradually, let's go ahead and then work your left leg straight out once more, unwind. Help your right leg up as well and just pause for a moment. Those little changes already present in through your back, your hips. Let your shoulders broaden once more. We don't want to pull the shoulders in towards the neck, so feel the space. Now from here, give a bend to your left knee. Place your left ankle to your right thigh. And then as comfort allows, start to bend your right knee and allow yourself to feel that nice stretch in through the left side of the buttocks, the back. What's the experience like for breath pattern? Is there a sense of balance? Are you drawing your inhale now to a count of five? Or do you find yourself holding your breath? If you are capable of bringing the breath into that deeper 4-5 count, play again with taking that extra inhale and really bringing in to the full capacity of your lungs, and then allowing a gradual emptying from the top of your lungs all the way down. And if you start to find a little bit more release taking place in through the left hip and bending your right knee is comfortable, by all means, feel free to try that out. If tonight's not the night, that's okay. You don't have to force. Breath in deep once more, just letting your mind stay in sync with the movement of breath. Release deeper into the left hip, the left side of your buttocks. The ease across the top of your shoulders, all the way out into your fingers. Full inhale as deep as you can comfortably receive. Empty it out slowly. Good, and then begin to extend your right leg straight out first. Unwind and help your left leg up as well. And just give a little turn to your ankles. Give them some release around your toes, your ankles. You can go one at a time, you can move them together at the same time, just starting to find that deeper sense of range of motion. Good, and then from here, we're gonna bend the knees, and I want you to be able to lie down flat into the space. So if you are in a space where you have your knees bent deep, go ahead please and allow yourself the opportunity to stretch out nice and long. I want you to allow your legs to separate. Really feel the distance and the length from your waistline out through the top of your head. Let your arms move away from the sides of the body and let the palms face up for just a moment. And then notice the length outward into your feet. Feeling the release in through the ankles and through the toes. And as you just pause here for a moment, checking in with the amount of ease as the body adjusts from that nice deep hip stretch. Notice how the belly responds. Is there tightness across the low section of your belly? Is there tightness at all in through the chest? And from here, I'd like for you to begin to walk both feet over to your right side. And as you move your feet to the far right side of your space, think of your feet moving beyond your right hip. So if you're not actually working on a yoga mat, that gives you an idea of the positioning of both feet. The legs are straight, your buttocks is level, it has not moved from the ground. And now picking up your right ankle, place it up on top of your left, and this will secure your left leg. Now this may be enough depending on how you're feeling today and through the left hip, the outer thigh. This may be enough. If your comfort level allows, I'd like to have you bend both elbows, push into your upper arms so that you can give a little wiggle of your head and shoulders to the right. So we're trying to move not only our feet to the right, we're also trying to move our head and shoulders to the right. So again, depending on your flexibility, you can let your arms come out either into T position at shoulder height. You're going to feel a little cattywampus here, that technical term, cattywampus. But just letting yourself start to find some of that release in through the left ribs. And let's bring our attention back again to the breath pattern, please. Feel your belly rise, your lower ribs expand, and the breath upward to the collarbones. And as you empty your breath, upper chest, mid chest, belly, and then from here, if your comfort allows for shoulders and upper back to bring your arms over your head, where your forearms and your elbows can both come down to the floor, I want you to place your right hand underneath your left wrist to support the left arm. And we're trying to increase the space now from waistline up into the armpit. For some, you may experience the stretch in through your left tricep as well, the back of your left upper arm. And as you, again, bring the breath in, as full and comfortable as body will allow, try to relax again across your shoulders, your upper back. Feel the release taking place in and around jawline, tongue, throat. You may just find that gentle surrender taking place at the muscular level. The lungs continue to receive comfortably and empty gradually. Let's bring the breath in full one more time. Now on your exhale, very, very slowly, start with your arms, then your head, your shoulders, and then bring your awareness down into your legs and start to separate in through the legs. Let your arms come down again to your sides so you can really level out and acknowledge that moment of pause. Check in with how different the left side's feeling now versus how the right side feels. Are you equal in your space? Are you still leaning more to the right side? So just give yourself that moment to feel that reconnection again to your body, to your space. Good, and then from here, we're going to move both feet to the far left side. And And as you move your feet over to the far left side, again, we're trying to bring the heels beyond the left outer hip. And then once you get to a comfortable space, then place your left ankle on top of your right. And you may stay here. This may be plenty. You may be getting enough stretch in through the right hip and side ribs. If you have the flexibility to increase the stretch, push into your elbows, give a little lift of your head and shoulders. And as you move your head and shoulders to the left as well, in banana pose, so that's what we're creating here, banana pose, we're giving all of that awareness in through now the right hip, side ribs. Find a comfortable space for your arms, whether it's out more at T position, it's like a tilted T, or if it's comfortable, bring the arms over your head, and now we'll rest the right wrist into the left palm of your hand. Now take note, how do the shoulders respond? You tighten up. You feel some ease created again into the neck, into the shoulders. What's the experience like for your breath? And play with that once again as you inhale, pause, and then try to inhale again. Really bring in more of the life force, and then hold before emptying the breath completely. Continuing to allow your breath to take you into that nice quiet space, quieting your thoughts, quieting the body. And being alert to how the body continues to respond. Next exhale, let's take our time. Start to unwind into your arms. A little push again into the elbows, the upper arms. Walk your head and shoulders back around to the neutral. Unwind your legs. Let your legs separate. Let your arms come down. And as you just pause for a moment, observing those nice adjustments in through hips, legs, relaxing around your ankles, your toes, feeling the release in through your back, your shoulders, and the back of your head. Let's let the breath draw in nice and full. And feel that gradual emptying taking place. And then from here, as you continue to keep buttocks and legs in the position that they're in, I'd like for you to reach your arms out shoulder height to your sides. So really feel the length outward through the arms. Now taking your left arm straight up towards the ceiling, we're now going to lift the back of the head and the left shoulder up and stretch all the way over with your left hand to meet your right elbow, forearm, wrist, or hand. Buttocks has not left the floor. The side, the right side of your head is now releasing down. And as the right side of your head continues to release down, just start to feel a little bit more ease in through your neck. So we're really capturing this nice twist in through the upper body. And as you're finding a little bit more twist through the upper body, again, try to relax once more in through your neck, your shoulders. Just letting buttocks release down once more. A couple more rounds of breath here, please. Inhale, take your time, lift your left arm up slowly, take your time, feel the adjustments, and then reach your left arm wide to your left, try to go straight out at shoulder height, and then pause, really acknowledging how much longer the left side of your body feels now and how the right side feels. Good. So make sure you're equal again and through your hips, your buttocks outward through your legs. Plant down once more in through your calves, your heels. Now take your right arm straight up towards the ceiling. And then we're going to lift the back of your head, your right shoulder, and then extend all the way over to try to meet either your left elbow, your left forearm, or if you can, interlace your fingers and still try to push the left forearm down towards the ground. Let the left ear and the side of your head release down. As you're feeling the length and through your right side, a nice bit of balance, again, in through your buttocks, your legs. towards the ceiling. Stretch your right arm out wide to your side once again. Feel the release and through your back, your hips, down into your toes. And then as the arms come down just a little bit towards the sides of your body, at a halfway point between shoulders and hips, continue to allow the palms to face up and just pause here for a moment. I want you to rock just slowly side to side onto the back of your head. Without lifting your head, I want you just to slowly roll your head from right to left and back over again to the right side. And check in, what's the range of motion like in through the neck? Is there tightness stored up? Is there flexibility? Is it harder to turn your head to one side than it is to the other? And then just slowly bring your head back around to neutral. Let's interlace the hands now behind your head and just let the back of your head rest into the palms of your hands. Fingers are interlaced. And as you continue to feel the length out through the feet, we're now going to lift the head up while still keeping the lower body at ease. And as you lift just your head, notice how the belly responds. We're giving it a little bit of strength. And we're bringing the chin down closer now towards the collarbones. And as your head is gradually lifting up, feel a little more stretch taking place in through the back of your neck. Allow your breath to deepen. Now, as you start to lower your head back, I want you to just pause. So I'm about halfway between where I was with my chin to my chest versus touching the floor. Let your elbows move out wider to the sides. We're going to do a little isometric movement now. And I want you to push the back of your head into your hands. And really feel the strength created around your neck. Push the back of your head into your hands one more time, as if you're trying to really push the back of your head down into the palms of your hands. Elbows continue to press wide to the sides. So we're giving strength now into the neck. This is not about tensing. This is about strengthening, so it's a little bit different sensation. You're going to start to feel your upper back giving you a little bit more support. Good, and now let your head come back down. Let your elbows stay wide to the sides. Yes. Fingers are still interlaced behind your head. And as you allow yourself to feel that bit of balance, I want you to continue to feel the elbows moving wide to the sides. And now we're going to lift the upper back in the back of your head, and then tip your right elbow down towards your right hip. The back of your head is still off the floor while you do this. So feel the power in through your belly. And now inhale, come back around. Pause, let the back of your head and your elbows move wide to your sides again. So we still have the fingers interlaced behind the head to create this. Okay, so fingers are interlaced still behind the head. Take in a deep breath. And now lift your head, your elbows, and now reach your left elbow down towards your left hip. Now this is like a variation of our banana pose that we did a moment ago, but we're concentrating now on the lifting of the head and the movement of moving left elbow down towards left hip. So feel your belly, feel the power in through your neck. Notice the strength that you're creating here. Again, nice full inhale. Good, and on your exhale, slowly unwind and bring the back of your head down. Allow your elbows to move wide to your sides. And then unwind. Bring the arms down to your sides as well, and feel how your triceps, the backs of your upper arms, respond once you start to release the arms down closer to your sides. From here, let's give a hug of the left knee inward towards your chest. As the left leg draws in, wrap your hands up around your left shin or knee, and then start to give a point and flex of your left foot. So the ankles loosening up, we're letting go of any of the tightness stored up into the left foot, ankle. And now take your right hand to the outer part of your left knee and begin to cross your leg over to your right. And as we cross left leg to the right side, now we want to keep the left shoulder down to help create a little bit more room. Take note again of your breath pattern. Take note of how the body softens one last little bit. All the space through the left side of your chest, the armpit outward into your left fingers, and the nice bit of range of motion as you're pivoting from the base of your shoulder blades down into your lumbar arch as the left knee continues to move to the right side of your space. Deep breath in again, please. Empty it slow. Now next inhale, take your time and begin to lift left knee back up and rest left foot down. Allow yourself to extend left leg straight out. Feel how long you are here in through your legs. Left leg may feel even longer than your right side. Now give a bend to your right knee. And let's start to hug right knee inward towards the chest. Point your toes, flex to your heel, point and flex, loosening up any tightness stored into right ankle. good. And then from here, take your left hand to the outside of right knee. Stretch your right arm out wide again to your right. And then cross your right leg over to your left side. And as your right leg is moving to the left side, notice once more, please, how the upper back and shoulders begin to nestle in towards the surface you're working on. And we're going to keep right shoulder blade down. This is where we gain the stretch in through the right side of the chest, in through the right armpit. So this is very supportive for your lymphatic system. Feel just a little bit more reach outward through right fingers. And then notice how different does the twist feel moving to your left side. Is there more freedom? Does this side feel tighter? Are you still balanced into both lungs? Body melt into the twist one last little bit. Good. Now on your next inhale, take your time, please. We're going to slowly lift right knee up. Just place your right foot down to the floor, level out again through your hips, and then hop your right leg straight out. And pause for just a moment. Feel the adjustments taking place one last time. Good. And then from here, as you continue to feel the length outward through your feet. If you are feeling cool and you would like to cover, I would encourage you to keep your body temperature fairly warm. So depending on how you're feeling, we're going to take our journey now into Shavasana, final relaxation. And as we pause, settling in, getting comfortable, I want you to feel the length equally out into both feet. And as you start to relax once more, cross your eyes, cross your forehead. You start to feel this gentleness around the forehead, around the back of your head, and we're letting go of any tension that may be stored around the temples, across your cheekbones. If you have on glasses, just placing those off to the side so your eyes and your face can truly begin to soften. Acknowledging now the distance down through the sides of your neck, the back of your neck, your throat, Bring your attention now to your right shoulder and let your right shoulder broaden. Even let your right hand move out a little bit wider. Make any adjustments again to your head, to your neck. Now, bring your awareness over to your left shoulder and allow your left shoulder to broaden. Allow your left arm to move out a little bit wider. And feel how the upper back begins to soften. This sense of broadening in through the chest, the shoulders, the upper back, giving your lungs the capacity to receive even deeper. And feel the distance from the nape of your neck all the way down to the very tip of your tailbone. Noticing all the spaces between, the spaces between your spine, the spaces between your ribs, the spaces between your organs. Now feel the space between the top of your inhalation and the bottom of your exhalation. Observing the fullness. And observing the emptiness. And with each exhale, just feel your body taking up a little bit more space as you soften, as you let go of any tightness stored up. There's this sense of ease, even into your organs, and acknowledging the distance from your waistline down to both knees. And as your knees grow softer, letting go of any tension stored across your legs, your hips, your back. And with your attention coming back to your knees, the awareness down into your ankles as the little toe sides of the feet gently turn outward and down, releasing any tightness stored up around ankles, tops of the feet, each of your toes, the soles of your feet, the arches of your feet. Feel then the backs of the legs growing softer and moving down against the surface that you're resting upon. As you inhale, the acknowledgement of all the freedom in through your back and through your shoulders. Feel the gentleness once more across the top of your head, your forehead, your eyes, your lips, your tongue, your throat. And as you acknowledge the gentleness deeper from within, giving thanks to your body, feeling a space of ease and gentleness. begin to deepen. Letting your attention come back to your body. Feeling the parts of your back making contact with the ground. Noticing the curves in through your back. And the awakening as you begin to move into your toes. As you begin to move and stretch in through your fingers, your hands. And just starting now to give room and space in through the body to actively begin to move and stretch. And as you start to find those spaces, moving and stretching, hands, feet, arms, legs, giving yourself the space to find freedom in through the body. As you give a bend to both knees, just let your eyes remain gently closed. And as you gently roll now to one side, you can start to slowly press yourself up to a seated position that's comfortable for you. And as you find your seat, finding that space of gentle awareness in through your spine, as you acknowledge all the beautiful changes in body, all the opportunity for body to create the space that it needed. As we bring our practice to a close, I invite you to fold your hands at your heart. And as you pause for a moment, the bow of your head looking deeper into your energetic heart center, moment to pause and acknowledge the divine within you. As you move into the remainder of your day, your week, giving yourself the time and space to have that moment of pause, to feel the adjustments, feel the earth beneath you. I thank each of you for sharing your practice, and may you continue to feel the light from your heart shining outward. I bow to each of you. Namaste.